Hello, welcome to Business World TV. Today with me is a very special guest, Professor Raghunath Shevgaonkar. He is the Vice Chancellor of Bennett University, which is a Times of India initiative. Before joining Bennett University, Professor Shevgaonkar had been associated with IIT Delhi, where he was the director. Before joining IIT Delhi, he taught engineering at IIT Bombay, and also he was Vice Chancellor of Pune University. He had been a reformist in the education sector, where he was one of the few people and the pioneers who spoke up about the autonomy of educational institutions. So today, I welcome Professor Shevgaonkar. Hello, sir.
Thank you.
How are you, sir? I know that Bennett University is one of the innovatively creative universities. But the first and the primary question to you is, because you are a veteran engineer, you have been teaching engineering for the last 30 to 40 years at least. So my question is, why is that engineering is still a very preferred course of study? And do you think so that after coming up of very courses which are creative, like liberal arts, mass communication, and courses on design and architecture, is engineering losing its sheen? What is your say?
So actually, if you really see, you know, last 10-20 years, the engineering suddenly was the prime focus for the students. And that has something to do with the quality of life which you get after graduating. There are more job opportunities, you know, if you do engineering degree, compared to if you had not done engineering degree. So that was one of the prime reason. And that's the reason you will see there are many engineering institutions which came in the country. But as the time is moving, now people are finding that no, there are other avenues also which are can give you good living. Like for example, architecture would be one area which could be there. So slowly, I wouldn't say engineering is losing the sheen, but yes, there are more opportunities which are becoming available. Children are also exploring different things. And just going by the herd mentality that everybody has to try for engineering, they are exploring different new things, you know, which are there, which according to their passion, and many more avenues are coming forward.
What are the initiatives that Bennett University is taking for the upliftment of the academic institutions in terms of the resources, in terms of the infrastructure, in terms of the international collaborations?
I must say that the Bennett University, it comes from the largest media conglomerate in our country. So the intention is to really create a world-class institution. Also, the institution is not only engineering focused, which many of the institutions which you will see. So this is a comprehensive university. So at this point of time, we have 4 schools. We have a school of engineering and applied sciences. We have a school of law, the school of management, and also the school of journalism or mass communication, and eventually it will become liberal arts also. So first thing, the emphasis which is there in Bennett is that can we create something which will run across these different schools? So creating something which is only engineering centric or only law or something management, one of our efforts is, can we create something which could be a combination of these things? And in that spirit, we are having a lot of flexibility which we are providing into our curriculum. So we are introducing the concept of minor. So you can get admission into one, but then you can do few courses and sort of get something, you know, in the other discipline also. So that is a multidisciplinary culture, which is one of the focus of the Bennett University. Second focus which the Bennett University has is the entrepreneurship. So right from day one, the message that we want to create tomorrow's entrepreneurs, that message is launched in the first year itself. And to do that, what we do is we offer courses, introductory courses on entrepreneurship, right from first year. So one course is compulsory, and they can take one or two more courses depending on what is their interest is. But everybody is exposed to the entrepreneurship, what it takes. And that is something which is normally not happens in the educational institution. And to support, if somebody comes up with an idea of starting his, you know, incubation or something, then we are having a Bennett hatchery, where there are dedicated people there who can help them to convert their ideas into a product. So the combination of the educational institution hatchery, which also links with the industry and get the support from the industry if they want to convert the idea into a product, I think this combination is something which is very, very unique into the Bennett. Third thing which is also important for Bennett is that right from beginning, the international collaborations have been emphasized. So right from day one, there are agreements signed with premier institution in US, the Georgia Tech, the Cornell University, and also the Babson College, which is for the entrepreneurship. So there is faculty which come from these institutions. They teach, you know, the short modules here for the students. Our students also can go to these places as interns. The entrepreneurship also, there are workshops which are conducted jointly or faculty here and there. So that culture that, you know, you should have an international exposure, I think that has been rooted in the system, you know, right from the beginning, very, very strong. So these are some of the strengths which the Bennett University has compared to many other universities.
What is your advice for the aspirants who are preparing for engineering exams? What should they focus?
Yeah, so if you really see in long run what you require, normally people think the content which you cover, you know, in the course, that's what is important, you know, in, you know, when you go out. In my opinion, content is really little less important. Of course, it plays some role, but that is not the thing. In long run, what helps you is your development of logical thinking. And that logical thinking comes many times from the fundamental and the basic sciences. Applications, you can build on that. Also, the application will keep on changing as the time moves. So those who are going for the engineering and technology, my first advice would be, create a strong foundation, okay, without worrying about the application which you can build later on. Technology will keep changing, but the foundation will not change. So anybody who wants to become a good professional in life, first initial few years, he should really create a good foundation. His fundamentals should be very, very strong. His logical reasoning should be very, very strong. And then if he builds on that, and then if he gets industrial exposure properly, I think he can really do the wonders into the society. So that's what my message would be, that don't ignore the foundation and the fundamentals, right? Make the foundation solid, and then you can always build applications on that. Your canvas is much bigger.
This was a little interaction with Professor Shevgaonkar, who has given us advice that how engineering students should be preparing. The discussion, as we have witnessed, was highly intellectual and erudite, and I am sure everybody is going to benefit from it. So on behalf of the entire Business World team and BWTV, I thank you, Professor Shevgaonkar, once again. Thank you very much, sir, for the interaction.
Thank you.